Now today, the students of class 10th are expected to have the book that is going to be taught here. The book, the name of the book is already written here. First flight. Two books are there in class 10, as you know. First one, the first flight, and second, you are knowing already, that is known as, I'm telling you, second one is a footprint without feet. Second one is quite surprising. Footprints without feet. पैर नहीं लेकिन फुटप्रिंट आ रहा है, ये भी काफ़ी सरप्राइजिंग, काफ़ी स्ट्रेंज है. और आप जब पढ़ेंगे तो फिर उसको आप देखेंगे भी वो उस तरह से कैसे है. लेकिन ये जो मेन बुक है जो आपको हम पढ़ाने जा रहे हैं, द बुक दैट इज फर्स्ट फ्लाइट. नाउ यू जस्ट राइट डाउन एवरीथिंग, माय कॉन्टैक्ट नंबर, इफ़ यू हैव एनी स्टार्टअप प्रॉब्लम यू विल कॉन्टैक्ट मी. चैप्टर्स नेम ऑलरेडी गिवन, फर्स्ट चैप्टर. And one thing more I would like to tell you, that without seeing the lines, words, nothing would be clear to you. That's why it is my request to open your book, see the lines, and the words are also there. If you want to have clear conception, lecture I can give, summary I can tell, but summary won't be sufficient. Without seeing the lines, because this is literature. In literature, without understanding the meaning of the line, meaning of the words, nothing would be clear. This is not the chapter or subject in which topics are dealt. Okay? So, see the books. I am going to start the first chapter, the name already given to you, A Letter to God. Very surprising it is. God exists. God has some existence. And suppose God has some existence, then who will write letter to God? Any sort of address is there? Do you know the address of God? Then how can you write a letter to God? Though the address is not known, but see the chapter, it is quite funny, quite interesting. Just I am going to read the lines to you. See, I will use both the languages, English and Hindi, both for your convenience. And I think you won't have any sort of problem if you are concentrating your mind to the lines, the books and the lecture I am giving you. Okay, the line in this way starts. Prologue is there, but it's not so useful in this chapter particularly, because the chapter is very simple. And then I am going to see the opening line or the opening paragraph also. You will just see the line. It's written here, the house, the only one in the entire valley, sat on the crest of Elohim. What is there? Crest. What is crest? Crest means the top level. Hill is there. The top of the hill, that is called crest. Leaf, peak, zenith. Many synonymous words are there. But you see, valley is there. A valley, a ghati hai. Or ghati means there is a solitary, only one house. And where is the house situated? Ghar hai ghati. So the house is situated at the crest, at the top of the hill. Okay, you must have understood the very line. Ab Hindi mein bhi aapne aapko bataya ki ek ghati hai, ghati just ek pahadi sa hai, uske upar wale top par ek ghar hai, solitary hai, only one, ek akela ghar. And it is written, from this height one could see the river and the field of ripe corn dotted with the flowers that always promised a good harvest. Words are there. Harvest. Harvest means upaj, yield. Jo bhi anaj aapka jo hota hai, wo harvest hai, wo aapka yield hai. Aise yield ka bhi bahut matlab hai, yield ka matlab jhukna bhi hota hai, walk mein, to surrender. Then yield ka yahan matlab ye bhi hota hai, kya harvest. Harvest ka aise bhi dusra bhi matlab hota hai. Harvesting of water. Harvesting of water means to just accumulate water, to store water somewhere. ये भी harvest का मतलब है. लेकिन हमको यहाँ पर देखना है, यहाँ जो मतलब है, what is the meaning applied here? Harvest means the very production of grains. ये अनाज जो है उसका जो उपज है उसके लिए आता है. तो in this way आप ये देख रहे हैं लाइन में कि from the height where the house was situated, from there one could easily see the fields and farms and the ripe corn. Corn also has got two meanings. First one is makka. Second, dhan. Dhan bhi aata hai. Lekin here, jaisa ki generally teachers bhi samajhte hain, bachche bhi samajhte hain, books wale bhi aisa word meaning mein diye rehte hain. Makka ke liye khas karke. It is particularly for maize. तो आपने देखा ये कुछ वर्ड्स आ रहे हैं जिसको आप लिख लेंगे राइप. राइप का मतलब क्या हो गया? पका हुआ. इस तरह से राइप कॉर्न है. राइप कॉर्न का मतलब ये पका हुआ है, काफ़ी पक गया है सब कुछ, लेकिन इट्स रिक्वायर्स अ बिट रेन ऑल्सो. ओके, तो ये लाइन आपका कह रहा है कि वो ऊपर के हाइट से आप देख रहे हैं. क्या देख रहे हैं? व्हाट आर यू सीइंग? तो आप देख रहे हैं ये क्या है, रिवर है, और फील्ड ऑफ राइप कॉर्न है, डॉटेड विद फ्लावर्स दैट ऑलवेज प्रॉमिस अ गुड हार्वेस्ट. फ्लावर्स आ गए. आप देखेंगे आप कॉर्न का जो प्लांट है उसमें उस ऐसे फूल्स वगैरह लगे होते हैं, उसमें वो सब दिखते हैं दूर से, तो कितना खूबसूरत, कितना ब्यूटीफुल दृश्य वो उपस्थित करते हैं. इस तरह से हो रहा है डॉट की तरह से काफ़ी ऊंचाई से देखने पर आप लगेगा कि द होल फील्ड इज फील्ड विद फ्लावर्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ स्मॉल स्मॉल डॉट्स. छोटे छोटे डॉट्स के रूप में वो सारे काफ़ी भरे हुए हैं. द ओनली थिंग द अर्थ नीडेड वॉज अ डाउनपोर और एट लीस्ट अ शावर. शावर दैट इज झरना, बट हियर शावर मीन्स रेन. ये माइल्ड रेन जिसको आप बोलते हैं, द माइल्ड रेन, वर्षा हो रही है और वो ये हल्की बारिश के लिए आ जाता है और जिसकी ज़रूरत है. द फील्ड द राइट कॉर्न रिक्वायर्स व्हाट? माइल्ड रेन. एंड इफ इट इज पॉसिबल downpour means sufficient rain also is expected. आप पर्याप्त काफ़ी बारिश होगा वो भी ठीक है चलेगा, लेकिन ऐसा कुछ ना हो जाए जैसे इसके बदले में instead of rain, instead of mild rain also, shower also, what happens? Suppose hailstones down, अब एक पत्थर पड़ने लगे तो भाई सब कुछ नष्ट हो जाएगा. फिर हमारे farmers जो हैं इसमें खास करके यहाँ जो mention किया गया है the name लेंचो, लेंचो जो कल्टिवेटर है, फार्मर है, वो तो बेचारा निराश हो जाएगा. भगवान ने कह रहे इस तरह की बात हो, लेकिन आगे हम लाइन को पढ़ाते हैं फिर देखते हैं. आप लाइन को देखते रहेंगे आपका सब कुछ क्लियर होता जाएगा. द ओनली थिंग द अर्थ नीडेड वॉज डाउन पोर. डाउन पोर आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड, रेन के लिए आगे, और फिर एटलीस्ट कम से कम शावर, उसका झरने की वजह से माइल्ड रेन हो तो भी चलेगा, ठीक है. थ्रू आउट द मॉर्निंग लेंचो who knew his fields intimately had done nothing else but see the sky towards the northeast. Throughout the morning time, in morning time, he was looking towards the sky and was expecting the downpour. He was doing nothing, he was having no work at all. Usko koi kaam nahi kar raha, just wo dekhte ja raha hai. He was looking towards the sky and he was at, in other sense you may say that he was requesting to God to give some rain because the crop was needing it. And in this way, आप इस लाइन को आप क्लियर समझ रहे कि फार्मर के मन की जो व्यथा है और उसका जो एक्सपेक्टेशन है, ईश्वर पूरा करते हैं कि नहीं करते हैं. ही इज फुल्ली डिपेंडेंट ऑन फार्मिंग. ये एग्रीकल्चर जो है उस पर डिपेंड करने वाले किसान कैसे टकटकी लगाए आसमान को देख रहे हैं और वो चाह रहे हैं कि कुछ बारिश हो जाए, ईश्वर कुछ ऐसा करे, ना कि कुछ हेलस्टोनर है, कोई पत्थर. ये भी वर्ड एक हिल है जिसका बहुत मतलब है. जब आएगा फिर हम आपको एक्सप्लेन करेंगे. आप आगे बढ़िए तो असल लाइन को देखेंगे हम लोग फिर आगे. तो इस तरह से आपने लाइन को देखा, उस पर एक नाम आया लेंचो. हु इज लेंचो? सपोज क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड, सपोज समबडी इज क्वेश्चनिंग हु इज लेंचो. लेंचो इज द कल्टिवेटर, ही इज अ फार्मर एंड ही इज एक्सपेक्टिंग गुड हार्वेस्ट. उसको काफ़ी अच्छी फसल की जरूरत है और वो आशा लगाए हुए कि थोड़ी बारिश हो जाए. देखिए क्या होता है, बारिश होती है या उसके बदले कुछ ऐसा नेचुरल कैलेमिटी, कुछ ऐसा कुछ आपदा हो जाए, कुछ गड़बड़ ना हो जाए, भगवान न करे. टाइम को आगे बढ़ाइए, देखते हैं. नाउ वी आर रियली गोइंग टू गेट सम वाटर. वुमन, हु इज द वुमन? हियर द वुमन रिफर्स टू, इट इज क्वाइट क्लियर, शी मस्ट बी द वाइफ ऑफ लेंचो. नाउ लेंचो इज कन्वर्सिंग विद हिज वाइफ. हिज वाइफ इज देयर, शी इज कुकिंग फूड for children, for his her husband, for herself also. But Lencho went there and he is sharing something with her. What does he share? See, First it is written, the woman who was preparing supper replied, yes, God willing. Means, if God wishes, if God wants, then definitely the downpour will occur. A barish hogi. If God doesn't wish, अगर गॉड की इच्छा नहीं हुई तो सब खत्म हो जाएगा. इस तरह से पूरी तरह से ईश्वर पर ये निर्भर है हर चीज़. ये दोनों वाइफ एंड हस्बैंड बोथ देयर स्पाउसेस आर टॉकिंग टुगेदर. और कैसे वो बता रही हैं, द ओल्डर बॉयज वर वॉकिंग इन द फील्ड व्हाइल द स्मॉलर वंस वर प्लेइंग नियर द हाउस अंटिल द वुमन कॉल्ड टू देम ऑल कम फॉर डिनर. नाउ इट्स रिटन अबाउट द सन्स ऑफ दिस these spouses, wife and husband. Older sons, older boys, they were doing their work, but the smaller ones, they were smaller, that's why they were having no work, they were playing just in the vicinity of the house, they were just moving here and there and playing, but time is up. Now, the mother of those boys wants all of them to come and to enjoy dinner. That's why she is just expecting all of them come for dinner to have something. Okay, the next line is there. It was during the meal that just as Lencho had predicted, big drops of rain began to fall. Good. Lencho had already predicted why and how, just by seeing the mountains of clouds hovering in the sky. The clouds that were hovering, वो जो घूम रहे हैं, मड़ा रहे हैं आकाश में, उसको देखते हुए लेंचो ने ऐसा एक प्रेडिक्शन था, उसका एक जम्पशन था. ईश्वर की लीला हो भी सकता है, नहीं हो सकता, उसके बदले में कुछ दूसरा हो जाए, इंस्टेड ऑफ रेन सब कुछ ऐसा कुछ हो जाए जो गड़बड़ हो जाए, लेकिन इसका एक प्रेडिक्शन था कि बारिश होगी. तो जब ये सारे बच्चे, व्हेन द बॉयज द फैमिली मेंबर्स वर टेकिंग और एंजॉयिंग द फूड, दैट टाइम रेन स्टार्टेड. व्हाट टाइप ऑफ रेन ड्रॉप्स, big ones or small ones or both? See now, the line is quite clear here. During the meal that just Lencho had predicted, big drops of rain began to fall. In the northeast, huge mountains of clouds could be seen approaching. Northeast, you are knowing already the direction. And the mountains of clouds were approaching means coming. And in this way, Lencho's heart was filled with pleasure and happiness. He was very much delighted. Why? Because God has listened to this farmer. Ye farmer jo request kar raha tha, jo expect kar raha tha, wo shayad ho gaya. Lekin phir dekhiye kaun sa mod leta hai ye. Likhta hai, the man went out for no other reason than to have the pleasure of feeling the rain on his body, and when he returned, he exclaimed, there are not raindrops falling from the sky, there are now coins. The big drops are 10-cent pieces and the little ones are fives. Cent, you are knowing already the word cent, this is unit of currency. In foreign countries, South Africa or America particularly, cent, dollar cent, shilling pence, ये सब कुछ ये विदेशी करेंसी है, उसमें ये छोटा यूनिट है. तो व्हेन लेंचो वेंट आउट जस्ट टू एंजॉय द टच ऑफ द रेन ड्रॉप्स ऑन हिज बॉडी, एट दैट टाइम ही सॉ दैट बिग रेन ड्रॉप्स वर फॉलिंग एंड ही इज कंपेयरिंग दोज बिग ड्रॉप्स ऑफ रेन विद 10 सेंट्स पीसेस एंड स्मॉल ड्रॉप्स 5 सेंट पीसेस. इन दिस वे इट वॉज अ मैटर ऑफ प्लेजर फॉर दिस पुअर फार्मर. This poor farmer was really very much delighted to enjoy the drops of rain. Some big drops, some small drops. बड़े बड़े जो drops थे उसको उसने compare किया किसी से 10 cent pieces, छोटे वाले को 5 cent pieces. इस तरह से altogether he was very happy to feel the raindrops touching the body of this man. And this way the next line is here. Written, the big jobs are 10 cent completed, para is changing. With a satisfied expression, he regarded the field of ripe corn with its flowers, draped in a curtain of rain, But suddenly a strong wind began to blow, and along with the rain, very large hailstones began to fall. See now, with a satisfied expression, he regarded the field of ripe corn with his flocks. Satisfied expression. The expression he was having, or he was giving, that was full of satisfaction. वह पूरा संतुष्ट से बड़ा हुआ स्पेशल था इन रिगार्ड द फील्ड ऑफ राइट कॉर्न विद हिज फ्लॉक्स ड्रेप्ड इन कर्टन ऑफ रेन ड्रेप ड्रेप मींस टू कवर कर्टन ऑफ रेन कर्टन मींस पर्दा कर्टन ऑफ रेन मींस बारिश के ऊपर पर्दे की तरह से कवर किए हुए पूरे राइट कॉर्न कवर्ड होल फील्ड ऑफ राइट कॉर्न इज कंप्लीटली कवर्ड कवर्ड विद व्हाट कवर्ड विद कर्टन ऑफ रेन्स But next time what happened is seen, it's given here. But suddenly a strong wind began to blow, and along with the rain, very large hailstones began to fall. Storm started and hailstones began to fall. Now thing became quite contrary, out of expectation. Hailstones, expect nahi kiya gaya, ye beyond expectation ho raha. Barish jiski umeed thi, वो बारिश की जगह ये हेल स्टोन आ गया. हेल वर्ड आपको समझा समझा दें. हेल का मतलब बहुत है, जैसे कि अगर आपका जो यहाँ है यहाँ हो गया वो बर्फ के छोटे छोटे या बड़े बड़े जो पत्थर हैं जो पीसेज हैं, ऐसे उसका दूसरा भी मतलब है. तो लेट मी नो फर्स्ट, हेल इज क्लियर टू यू अकाउंट. हेल हैज गॉट टू मीनिंग्स आर पर्टिकुलरली हियर आई एम जस्ट गिविंग यू. हेल हेल मीन्स इजेस पीसेज ऑफ आइस. आइस स्टोन यू नो. That is another meaning to hail. I hail from Patna. I hail from Delhi. Hail means to belong to. To belong to. I belong to Delhi. I belong to Patna. It's another meaning. Hail has third meaning also. Hail means to greet someone, to welcome someone, to wish someone. In this way, hail has got different meanings. And in this way, I am telling you that this very thing, the very word, and the word stock must be enhanced. If you are not enhancing the word power, the word stock, literature will become difficult for you to read the lines and understand the things. That's why you write down the words also. Okay? Sufficient space is not here. Otherwise, I might be writing also. But you are matured because I am teaching the students of class 10, not class 9. And you are wise enough, you can write down the meaning of words, and that's why I'm giving a little bit pause also, okay, for your convenience. Now let us start. These truly did resemble new silver coins. Resemble, what is there? Resemble means to have similarity. Resemblance. Your face resembles your mother. Your face resembles your father, suppose, resembles, to have similarity. It's just the similarity in the way we have, resemble, or the matlab hai, usme samay na ko banate hue hum aapko bataye ki aage meaning kya hai. So this truly did resemble new silver coins. New silver coins. It is very good thing. New silver coins, those were compared with silver coins because they were silvery in color. Small pieces or big pieces, 10-cent pieces, 5-cent pieces, they were silver in colors. And actually water has no color, colorless. But he is just assuming that they are looking quite silvery. The boy is exposing themselves to the rain, ran out to collect the frozen pearls. Here the hailstones are compared with frozen pearls. Pearls means moti. ये फ्रोजन जमे हुए मोती हैं और ये कितने खूबसूरत लग रहा है. लेकिन जो लॉस हो रहा है वो एक किसान समझ रहा है. क्या लॉस हो रहा है हम लोग आगे क्लियर कर लेंगे. पहले यहाँ देखिए, हाउ चिल्ड्रन आर एंजॉइंग द ड्रॉप्स ऑफ स्मॉल स्मॉल पीसेज ऑफ आइस. तो इन दिस वे यू सी हियर दैट बच्चे द बॉयज आर कलेक्टिंग ऑल those pieces and they were just enjoying. Next, it's really getting bad now, exclaimed the man. I hope it passes quickly. It didn't pass quickly, For an hour the hail rained on the house, the garden, the hillside, the cornfield, and the whole valley. The field was white, as if covered with salt. No words are difficult here. Some words, I think, it was known to you. Hillside you are knowing already. It's really getting bad now. The whole scenario is now changing. The happiness of this farmer, this poor farmer, is now converting into sorrows. Sorrow and misery and pain that is coming to this man. Why? Because these pieces of hails are just ruining the field. The whole field is ruined, getting ruined. And in this way, he is saying it is really getting bad now. ये बहुत खराब हो रहा है. ये सारे पिट जाएंगे, सारे फसल बर्बाद होंगे. Exclaimed the man. To exclaim means अभिव्यक्त. ये exclaim करता है कि it's really getting bad. ये get का मतलब क्या हो गया? Become. यहाँ पर ऐसे तो get का मतलब to have. आप समझ रहे हैं. I am getting remuneration. I am getting my salary. Many things like that. But यहाँ पर have ये become get का मतलब have के से have हो गया और become हो गया. ऐसे आपको हमने बता दिया. I just get it means have it. हाँ, I just tell you that get this book. तो it means you have this book. और get का दूसरा मतलब क्या होगा? Become. तो यहाँ become के सेंस में ये दे रहा है. It's really getting bad now. It is becoming bad now. Exclaimed the man. I hope it passes with you. What was the hope? What was the expectation? It will finish. But it will become quite different. What happened? It didn't pass quickly. For an hour the hail rained on the house, the garden, for 1 hour. Kept on raining. It didn't stop. But what was the expectation? Expectation was that it will pass quickly. In no time, it will finish. But no. For 1 hour completely, it went on raining. It kept raining. And in this way, everywhere on the house, the garden, the hillside, everywhere, those small or big pieces of hails were coming down. They were just beating. And in this way, the crops were getting spoiled. Cornfield on the whole valley, the field was white as if covered with salt because of the color of the small or big pieces of ice. The whole field was looking what? White. As if salt had spread everywhere. The whole field is covered with salt. Now the change and the very expectation. Just to see the farmer, he is full of pain and misery. This man is now very much sad. Next para just is given here. The thing is just giving pain to this man. Next one, not a leaf remained on the trees. Why? Because of the beating of the hail. Hail, the pieces like the stone type, hailstone that is called. Hailstone, they were just beating all the leaves, and in this way all the leaves had fallen down. ये सारे पत्ते जल गए, सारे पत्ते गिर गए. और इस तरह से लिखता है कि the corn was totally destroyed. Destroyed means ruined. सारे फसल बर्बाद हो गए, completed. The flowers were gone from the plants. Flowers, where were the flowers? They gone from plants. It means both were attached. Plants means ripe corns were having flowers. They were completely ruined, destroyed, damaged. Now the beauty that was there in the beginning, the whole field was looking beautiful with the dots of flowers. There was no beauty. And later on, the thing, the crops also will be completely destroyed. And see the lines, it's written here. Next line. Lencho's soul was filled with sadness. Soul, you are knowing, so human. Soul, that is Atma. और ये यीशु ही नहीं है जो आप सोल समझते हैं, पैर के नीचे वाले भाग, वो नहीं है. यीशु यूएल है जो आत्मा है, जो परमात्मा का अंश है. उसके बारे में बात हो रही है. वो कह रहा है कि लिंचो's soul was filled with sadness. लिंचो की आत्मा जो है उदासी से पूरी तरह से भर गई. ये बहुत उदास हो चुका है बेचारा, एक्सपेक्टेशन काफी फाइल्ड हो गया इसका कंप्लीटली. व्हेन द स्टॉर्म हैड पास्ड, ही स्टूड इन द मिडिल ऑफ द फील्ड एंड सेड टू हिज सन्स, अ प्लेग ऑफ लोकस्ट वुड हैव लेफ्ट मोर देन दिस, द हेल वाज हैज लेफ्ट नथिंग दिस ईयर, वी विल हैव नो कॉर्न. व्हाट इज देयर लोकस्ट, व्हाट इज लोकस्ट, ऐसे उसको हिंदी में हम लोग टिड्डी कहते हैं. तो टिड्डी का पूरा समूह, पूरा दल वो खेतों पे उतरता है और पूरे फसल को बर्बाद कर देता है. तो इस तरह से वो टिड्डी का जो दल है, समुदाय है, वो लोकस्ट है, उसका जो वो वंश है वो पूरा आ गया और पूरे फसल को बर्बाद कर दिया. तो वो जो बर्बाद करता है उसको कंपेयर कर रहा है कि वो थोड़ा बहुत छोड़ भी देता है, समथिंग इज लेफ्ट बाई देम. बट यहाँ प्रकृति की मार ऐसी है ना, गॉड ने ऐसा कर दिया कि वो तो जो भी किया इस लोकस्ट से भी खराब हो गया. ये लोग तो कुछ छोड़ नहीं देते थे, दे यूज्ड टू लीव समथिंग, बट गॉड ने सब बर्बाद कर दिया. ये कंपैरिजन कर रहा है अ प्लेग ऑफ लोकस्ट. प्लेग मीन्स प्लेग, एक बीमारी का भी नाम है, दूसरा भी मतलब है प्लेग, मतलब एक ट्रबल, जैसे हम आप कहते हैं परेशानी. तो ये प्लेग उस ट्रबल के लिए, डोंट प्लेग मी का मतलब क्या होगा, डोंट ट्रबल मी. इस तरह से इस प्लेग का भी दो मीनिंग है और आपको लिखना है कॉपी में लिखना है. तो एक आप देख रहे हैं कि प्लेग ट्रबल कर लिया रहा है और एक तो बीमारी है प्लेग, जो कि आप जानते हैं जिसको पूरी तरह से खत्म भी किया जा चुका है. लोकस्ट वुड हैव लेफ्ट मोर देन दिस, वो तो इसे ज्यादा भी छोड़ देता है, लेकिन ये सब कुछ नष्ट कर दिया. द हेल हैज लेफ्ट नथिंग दिस ईयर, वी विल हैव नो कॉर्न, हेल हैज नॉट लेफ्ट एनीथिंग. And this year there would be no harvest, nothing would be there to eat to survive on this earth. And God has become so merciless. God is merciful, but now God has become merciless. Why? Because of this natural calamity. Okay, nowadays we are facing it already. Now, the lines given below, a few lines are there. Just to see the books. That night was a sorrowful one. One here means, one also has got meanings, different meanings. One means eight. But here one is used as pronoun. And this is for which noun? So the word is here. The night, or that night was a sorrowful one. Sorrowful night. Woh raat, badi dukh se bhari hui raat. Ye aisi raat ho gayi jo है सारे के सारे इनमेट्स ऑफ द फैमिली वर फिल्ड विद सॉरो एंड सैडनेस. ये काफ़ी दुख में ये लोग दम से पड़े हुए हैं. ऑल आवर वर्क फॉर नथिंग, ऑल आवर वर्क मीन्स ऑल द लेबर, ऑल द वर्क दे हैड डन ऑलरेडी प्रीवियसली, सारे के सारे वर्क समाप्त हो गए हैं. ये क्या हो गया? देर इज नो वन हु कैन हेल्प अस, no one was there to assist this man. God hasn't assisted this man, then how? What is the capacity of a man, human being? Limited capacity a man is having. So there is no one. And next line he is saying, we will go hungry this year. Now the members are thinking that they would die of hunger. They would not survive. Why? Because there would be no grain to eat. Then survival was not possible. In this way, the happiness of the farmer. The farmer in the beginning predicted something, that something good was going to happen. But what happened? You don't know the future. It is unpredictable. Anything might happen. Nobody can predict. Your work is to do something, not to predict anything. Now everything has changed. In this way today time is up and I am going to stop it. Tomorrow we will come again and